Hi guys, and welcome for this new episode of EatTheBlocks. So today it's going to be the first step of the special series on how to build an Ethereum distributed application with Solidity and JavaScript. So for the first step, we're going to be building the smart contract. You can check on GitHub if you want to have the code. There is a folder for each of the steps. So if you're lost at any moment, you can just download the code of the previous step. So for this step, we're going to start from scratch. So there is nothing to worry about. All right, so let's jump to our terminal and create a new folder. And in this folder, we're going to run a truffle init command to jumpstart our truffle project. So those are the folder you should see after. And then we're going to create our smart contract with the truffle create contract plus the name of our contract. So it's going to be ToDo. Okay, so we're going to execute this. And then switch to your text editor, and that's what you should see. Okay, so we can get rid of our constructor because we don't need it. So the first thing we need to define is our task object. So in Solidity, we can represent custom object with the keyword struct. So that's basically like an object in other programming language. Then we need to name our struct. So it's a good practice to name your object, your struct, sorry, with an uppercase letter. So we're going to call task with an uppercase T. And then we open the curly braces and we will define the field of our struct. So the first field is the ID field, which will be represented by an integer. Then the second field will be the date. So a date in Solidity can be also represented as an integer. Then we're going to have another field, which will be the content of our task. So it will be a string. Then we will have another string, which is the author of the task. And finally, we will have a Boolean field, which will represent the done or not done status of the task. Okay, so we have our task struct. So the next thing we need is a way to represent a collection of tasks. So because we'll be creating several of those tasks. So for this, we will create a dynamic array of tasks. So for this, we will reuse the task name that we created before, and we're going to add those brackets. So that's basically how you say, I want a dynamic array of my custom struct type. And we're going to name this task with an S. Okay. So now we need a way to create a new task. So for this, we're going to create a function. So create task. And this function is going to accept two arguments. So the first one is a string, which represents the content of our task. And we're going to prefix this variable with an underscore. And we're also going to need another argument, which is the author of the task. Okay. So this function has a public visibility. So I specify this just because it's a good practice to specify the visibility, but the default visibility of a function in Solidity is public, so it's not strictly required. Okay, now I'm gonna define the body of this function. Basically, I'm going to reference the collection of tasks that we just defined before, tasks with S, and I'm going to execute the push function because task represent an array. So an array in Solidity has a method which is called push, which can create a new entry. And in this new entry, I'm going to create a task. So how I'm going to do this? So I'm going to write task like this, name of my struct. And inside the parentheses, I'm going to write all the fields that are required to create this task. So first, we need an ID. So how are we going to create an ID? It's very simple. So we're going to use the length field of our task array. So at the beginning, the length of our task array is 0, so the first ID is 0. And then when we're going to re-execute this create task function a second time, the length of the task array will be 1, so the second ID will be 1, etc., etc. I think you get it. Okay, now we need a date. So the date of the task is at the moment of the creation. So in Solidity, we can use the now keyword. The content will be the first variable that we pass to this function. The second variable will be the author. Oh, by the way, I forgot to prefix it by an underscore. So I'm going to do this now. And we also need the Boolean status, done or not done. So at the beginning, our task will not be done. So we're going to pass the false value here. And here I need a semicolon. And that's okay. So now I can create my task. Okay. So the second thing we need is a way to access our task. So for this, we're going to create another function, get task, which is going to accept an integer here. This integer will be the ID of the task. After I need to specify the public visibility, and it's going to be a constant function, which means that it's not going to modify any data. And then I need also to specify the returns value of this function. So because they're going to be many fields, I'm going to create a new line. And I'm going to use the returns keyword. And the first type of value that we're going to return is a uint, because that's the ID. And after the ID, we're going to return the date. So it's also a uint. And after this, we're going to return a string, which is the content, another string, which is the author, and finally a Boolean value, which represents the done status of our task. Okay, so now we can open the curly braces to define the body of our function. And very simply, it's going to return all the fields of our task. So the first field is the ID. So for this, we don't need to access the task. We can just return the ID that we passed as an argument to the function. Then the second field that we're going to return is the date. So for this, I access the task array, and the index, it will be ID. And then I want the date field. Okay, I'm going to copy paste this and going to repeat this for the next few lines. So I will have the content, author, and the done status. So here, content, here, author, and here I want the done field. Okay, now I need to add some comma here, because the linter is not happy. Okay, and here after the return statement, I need a semicolon. Okay, and my linter should be happy now. Yes, it's the case. So what will be written here is a tuple of different value, and Web3 will be able to interpret this. Okay, and now the final thing we need is another function where we can have all the tasks. So for this, we're going to define a function that is called getTask, doesn't take any argument. It's also a public function with a constant keyword, and it's very simply going to return all the tasks. So the array of tasks that we defined before, and we didn't specify the return type of this function, so my linter complain. So here I use the returns keyword, and it's going to return an array of tasks. So that's how I define this. Okay, so now I save, and my linter should be happy. Okay, so seems like everything is fine. So now I switch back to my terminal, and now I need to create a migration file. So I already did this many times in previous episodes, so I'm not going to re-explain. So you can find the migration file in the GitHub repo. The link will be in this video description. Very quickly, I just cat this. So don't be panicked. So which one is it? 1, 5. Okay, so it's a very simple migration file. I cannot do any more simple. Okay, so let me clear my screen. And so now we're going to start our local testnet with the truffle develop comment. Okay. Okay, so our local testnet is started and truffle injected and a contract artifact which represents our smart contract. So it's this to-do variable I'm referencing. And I want to catch I want to have a JavaScript variable that points to the deploy instance of my contract. So for this, I execute the deploy method. And then I'm going to be return a promise. And with this promise, I can access the deploy smart contract. So is the syntax okay? It looks okay. So let's execute this. And no, it's not okay. So what's the problem here? ToDo is not defined. Oh, it's because I forgot to run the migration. So first we need to migrate. Okay. Because when we start the local testnet, it's a brand new testnet without anything deployed on it. So we do need to run this migration command that will make use of the migration file that we created just before. And now I can actually rewrite the same line as before. So deployed, then I create my ins variable to which I assign the live contract. And here I must not forget the arrow operator, otherwise it's not going to work. Okay, and now it should work. And it still doesn't work. Oh my god, what's the problem? Okay, it seems like the truffle console is very demanding. Sometime, for some weird reason, it doesn't work, and you need to retype everything. It's a little bit annoying. Okay, so truffle console, will you be happy this time? Seems like everything is perfect, right? Is it? Yes, okay, it works. And now if I type inst and I press enter, then I can see my smart contract instance. Okay, so now with our inst variable, we're going to be able to execute some method of our smart contract. So the first one we're going to try is a create task method. And the first argument of the create task method is the content of our task. So my task content here. And the second argument is the author. So we're going to write my name, Julian. Okay. And this is going to return a promise. So we could do something like then console log. But it's not necessary because the truffle console is going to do it for us. So we just press enter and we should be returned a transaction. Okay, so now we need to check if our task actually exists. So for this, we're going to execute the get task method. The ID of the task is 0 because that's the first one that we created. Okay, so let's execute this. And here we can see that we have a task return. So the first two fields are the ID and the date represented with the big number type that we could convert to a more a human understandable representation, but we're not going to bother because we can already check that everything worked because we have our content field, which is my task content, our author field, which is Julian, and our done status, which is false here. Okay, so we have what we were expecting. And the last thing we need to try out is to get all the tasks. So for this, we're going to execute the get task method. This time, no argument. And we're going to press enter. And we have an error. Okay, so what is the reason of this error? So here, it's an error invalid solidity type. Array of tuple. Okay, so that's a little bit misleading. It's not really a problem with Solidity itself. It's more a problem with Web3 that cannot understand what is written because what is written is an array of a custom type. So it's not a type which is defined in Solidity, and Web3 doesn't know yet how to handle this. So maybe for future version of Web3, this will be updated. But at the moment, we cannot access our collection of tasks the way we did it. That's it for this video. So today we've built a basic smart contract for our ToDo application. So it's functional, but as you can see, there are still some problems. In particular, the getTask function doesn't work. So for the next step of this series, we're going to fix this problem and we're going to complete the smart contract, which still misses some part. If you like this channel, you can give me a like, or you can subscribe, or you can post something in the comment. If you have any question, I'll be really happy to help to the best of my abilities. I hope to see you for my next video, and it's time for me to tell you, see you next time, guys. Bye-bye.